All right, we're good.
Cool. All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the SteelSeries Southeast Asian Cup Season 4. This is Game 2 of a best of 3 between Titan and Loya.net Esports. Thank you, of course, to SteelSeries for sponsoring this tournament, and shout out to DapBet.net Esports Betting. Thanks to DotaTalk for very kindly allowing me, Lily, and co-caster Pimp Muckle for casting this. So, sup, Pimp?
Hi. So, it was a nice game last game, to be fair. Really enjoyed it, especially with the KYX way plays going around with a Miracle inside him. Just pretty much killing everybody. And he also needs a team fight with it. It's so balls to the walls play. I really enjoyed it. So I hope we see another pretty aggressive lineup from Titan coming out, or of course from Lowit as well. It's not like I'm biased or something. It's just I want some action.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good play there by Titan, especially good drafting, I have to say, by Miracle. I mean, he did ban out heroes, indicating he wanted to take the Storm Spirit, getting rid of the Viper as well as the Puck, but Loyat still decided not to pick up any stuns, really. So, I mean, Miracle really peaked it with that Storm Spirit pickup, and Loyat had nothing really to respond to it. And it is something that Loyat tends to do, where they go for I guess a tri-core lineup with three carries. And I mean, that can work great if you manage to make it to the late game. But unfortunately, last game they picked up two level and item dependent supports with Visage as well as Sand King. And unfortunately, Titan really just punished them for it, I suppose, and didn't give them a chance to get the supports up any items. So in team fights, they were dying pretty much instantly and weren't able to do as much damage as they probably would have liked. And I mean, now I wonder if Loyal are going to be picking another tri-core lineup or if they're going to be going for something a bit more ganking oriented. But I mean, first pick Mirana, so it doesn't reveal too much. She has played as a support sometimes. She's also played as a carry or as a mid hero, or really, she has a variety of different roles she takes. So I would say that Mirana doesn't say, too much about their lineup.
Wow, out for Jevura. This is revealing the hand quite early. But I mean, KYX plays a mean outworld Jevura, so maybe they're just looking to make a go in the mid game, get the BKBs and the mech up, and rush. Well, let's see. Elder Titan. Wow. Well, that's quite standard. I mean, the Elder
I
Titan,
don't
not
know.
the OD.
Yeah. I don't know. Elder Titan has kind of been a hit or miss. He seems to be in most games either, picked up or, ignored. I guess he gets first planned, or he just gets ignored, or he gets, picked up in the first couple of picks. I mean, I haven't really seen him. He's not like how Batrider was, I suppose, is what I'm trying to say. He wasn't, first picked up or banned instantly. He's just kind of like jittering in and out. But he is still a reasonably strong hero in those mid to early game team fights, I suppose, once he gets up the max on that, what you call natural order. And it does combo quite well with the Owl Devourer, since Owl Devourer does a lot of magical damage with the Sanity's Eclipse. And if you've got one of those Astral Spirits out there camping the team fight with the Natural Order as well as possibly even an Earth Splitter, I mean, that could be a team down. And Loyal are going to have to consider what kind of heroes they pick up. So it looks like a DK could do quite well because of that plus armor, but I mean, that would mean that Loyal would have to have a bit more of a push-oriented lineup picking up the DK. So I don't know. Titan with those two pickups are just saying, "Hey, we're ready to team fight, so come at us." And Titan themselves might decide to go for a bit more pushing oriented lineup, picking up maybe a, I don't know, maybe a Pugnar or something like that. Probably not, but I mean, they could definitely play a four protect one, so just four heroes team fighting one Miracle farms up.
Well, it's not unheard of Titan. It's usually how they win. Well, in the last few weeks, they win their games just with Miracle doing amazing on the spiritual side of things, and in the meantime, just the whole other team of Titan occupying their enemy, just going ham, pretty much all out aggression coming out, and I really like to see that. So Slark ban and a Visage ban. I mean, Slark has seen a big increase in his popularity pretty much in every scene in the world, so not too surprising to see him banned out. He can be played as one position, as an offlaner. He's pretty versatile. He can do very well if he gets his early lead with the power treads and the drums and or an Eye of Skadi later on. So not too much giving away yet. But the thing with Loyat is they are looking to make a go in the ganking page pretty much, because the Nyx assassin, he's an excellent ganker. Mirana, she's a great ganker as well, and they don't have that much of a team fight. So we'll see if they follow their route with the all-out ganking, or if they want to get some more team fight in.
Yeah, I mean, think typically from what we see from Loyat, they don't really shy away from team fights, I suppose. But normally the way they win is just by having, an item advantage. But at the moment, I would say they don't really have an item advantage. In terms of their heroes, I mean, Nyx Assassin, he needs levels again. Mirana needs levels, and I don't know, I think teamfights are going to be pretty hard for them to take, so maybe they're going to be better going for a bit more split pushing and ganking oriented lineup. I mean, they can't take any of those hardcore gankers, I would say. I mean, Storm Spirit is probably out of the deal at the moment, but maybe they could run an aggressive tri lane with something, I don't know, like a Klinx or something in the easy lane who can just split push and get some pickoffs so that anyone from Titan is alone. And I mean, like, you weren't watching earlier today, but we saw Titan versus Insidious Idol earlier in this cup, and I mean, Titan just demolished Insidious Idol, really, just by playing such a hyper aggressive early game drafting style. They would just get the pickoffs early, and Insidious Idol didn't really have time to kind of snowball themselves forward, and it looks like Titan are going to be happy to do that again. Just picking a superior team fight lineup and maybe, you know, backing this up with a hard carry that can do a bit of damage in the early game, something like a Lifestealer or a Luna. Well, Luna's been banned out, so not her, but, you know, a Lifestealer or who else? Juggernaut, something like that, who can help out but can also go AFK farm if he needs to.
Yeah. And a Shadowdeam. Wow, he's quite a defensive support, I would say. And he doesn't have the biggest teamfight impact. Of course, he can save his carries with a big disruption. We saw that yesterday from First Departure, just saving the whole game with one big disruption. And of course, his perch goes through the magic immunity, so they have something to, you know, limit the movement in a teamfight. But he doesn't have really a teamfight presence per se. So they will have to pick up something else if they want to do a teamfight. Or maybe they will just go like, well, we don't care, we just go gank you all your lanes every day, and we'll just like shut you down in the early phases. But with the Bane, it's going to be hard.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like just ganking is what they're going for with the Shadow Demon initiation, with the disruption followed up by either a Nyx's Essence down or straight into an arrow. But I mean, against a Bane, you know, if Bane catches sight of the Shadow Demon, he's just going to sleep them or sleep the Mirana or Fiend's Grip someone. I mean, Bane is a crowd control hero king. It's very, very hard to team fight versus Bane just because he's able to take down so many heroes at once. He can take away the damage from the carry, he can Fiend's Grip whoever's got the BKB, and he can nightmare someone else. And that really does make it quite difficult for Loyat to actually take some fights. And Titan picking up a 10 now as a second support, so I think they will be pushing quite aggressively. They're going to go for some pickoffs and maybe waiting until probably more like the 10 to 15 minute mark, once they've got maybe a mech on the Outworld Devourer and possibly a 4 staff as well. As well as, you know, there's enough levels that Elder Titan and Outworld Devourer can just dominate team fights. But once they get to that point, I can imagine they're probably going to be pushing the high ground quite early into the game. And I mean, this is the same style of lineup we saw when they versed Insidious Idol this morning, because they were pushing the high ground at 20 minutes. The game went for another 20 minutes, went for 40 minutes total, but still, 20 minutes into the game, Titan had all the outer towers down, they had the Roshan up. They went for a Shadowfiend carry, so maybe we're going to be seeing that again coming out from KYXY, but actually it's a miracle playing, so maybe they won't. But still, I mean, Titan just played very, very aggressively and had the game, you know, in their hands, in their control from around about the like 15 minute mark. It was their game to take, and Loyat just couldn't get the not Loyat, but Insidious Idol couldn't get the ganks off. So I'm expecting something similar coming out from Titan now, where Loyat are wanting to get ganks, they're wanting to get pickoffs, but they're just not gonna find any room. And they're going for a bounty hunter as well, so they are just going for ganks. That's it. They wanna get kills.
Yeah, Bounty Hunter is a great addition to the already very aggressive lineup. If you can get the ganks with a Bounty Hunter, you will snowball from it, and you will have such a large amount of gold above your enemy, and it can really make the difference, just because you will have the core items on your carries up a little bit faster, and you don't really need to farm as much as you would without a Bounty Hunter, just because of the crack gold, the track gold giving immense money to the team. And also the supports won't be staffed. So that's great. And on the other hand, Titan supports will have to buy some dust or some sentries, so they will starve a bit. I mean, it's Chen, he will get some farm up, no doubt about it. And the Bane, usually with some big ganks, he can have some nice impact as well, but still, it's something, and it's something taken away from Titan.
Yeah, I mean, I guess taken away from Titan, but Titan, I think they're just going to be looking at picking up a carry at this point and banning out that the Morphling. It's a little bit cheeky because Loyat are known for having a very strong Morphling player with Lance, so Lance not going to be able to play that Morphling that he loves so much. But, I mean, still, Loyat now, they want to ban out a carry, so Titan can't pick it up. And at the moment, Titan can play a very easy 4 protect 1. Well, they've got one hero just AFK farming. Banning out the Morphling means that maybe it's going to be a split pusher. Maybe something like an anti-mage, possibly, but at the same time, they could just decide to go a little bit more early game and just pick up something that can, you know, help fight from the get-go. I'm kind of interested to see what Miracle is going to take, because he is known for playing heroes that, I guess, aren't quite the norm, per se. Heroes that you don't see much in the competitive metagame, so I do wonder what exactly he's considering taking. Maybe for something like a sniper, honestly. That'd be funny. But I mean, yeah, they could be running Morana carry, or they could be picking up a carry for themselves. Though there aren't really very many carries left in the pool. Pretty much all the very competitive viable ones have been banned out thus far, and it's going to have to be a bit of a niche pick for both teams, in fact.
Yeah, it's interesting that Titan banned out the Morphling. I didn't expect that at all, because I don't see a Morphling fitting into this lineup from low yet. But, well, we'll see what Titan decides to pick up. They don't have that much time anymore, 50
30
seconds to
seconds
make up their
remaining.
minds, and then we'll see what's going on. I would assume it's another, yeah, it's another early-ish hero. He will get the mech up or the Aghanim Scepter, depending if the Outworld Devourer wants to rush a 4 stuff, or a mech, of course, and then they will just make a go. And Viper's great in the early game. I mean, no doubt about it. They can push, they can make the game very hard for low yet to counter push. And if anyone just shows the face, if they're gonna siege these towers, it's gonna be a poison sting and a Viper strike to the face. And we'll see some nice aggression. I really like the lineup coming up from Titan.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I mean, I think this Viper probably going to be rushing, I would say, an Aghanim
5
Scepter,
seconds remaining.
though. I mean, it's a very interesting pickup, honestly. It's not what I was expecting from them, but I guess they are just going to be going full and aggressive. It does help them push down towers in the early game, since Viper's passive does work on towers to, I think, half the effect, isn't it, or something like that.
Oh, I won't say
What is
anything.
it?
I don't want to get crucified by Jett.
Half damage to creeps and buildings, so going to do half damage to buildings. So, that's going to give them a decent ability to push down towers in the early game. And Enigma, the last pickup for Lowyard, so Morana must be playing the carry. And DDZ mid on the Nyx Assassin, they're going for pretty greedy on Lowyard, picking up a jungler as well. But I do like that because Titan's lineup, like I was saying, it doesn't really come online until a little bit later. They need levels, they need some farm, they need Bane to be pulling, and I think Viper must be farming, I suppose. Viper wants to get up a couple of items out, while Devourer wants a 4-star or a mech or something like that. So Lowyard have got the room to pick up a jungler of their own and just contest farm, really. So Miracle's playing the Outworld Devourer. Must be a mid lane OD, I guess. Or it could be an easy lane OD.
Yeah.
Viper versus mid lane Nyx Assassin. How's that gonna go?
I would assume the
Seconds
Viper wins.
remaining.
But I'm not that big of an expert on mid lane matchups. I think Viper is a very strong mid lane against pretty much all the heroes which are melee. So we'll see how it goes. And let's see if Lowyard wants to make some rotations going into the mid lane, because Viper's he does have his passive up, of course, pretty early into the game usually, but if he decides to skip it, he is a very easy gank on the mid lane. So we'll see if Lowyard wants to make a go there. But what is your thought
Yeah,
on
it
the
is.
Enigma pick?
I think it's really smart. I think it's going to work out quite well. It gives them a bit more AoE, ability to push down towers, and a mech carrier. So it gives them a whole bunch of things that they were missing. And he should be able to get some farm up. He's not going to have, a dual roaming, sanking Lina, ganking in the jungle constantly. So he should be good. But do you want to go through Lowyard quickly, and then I'll go through Titan?
Yep, we have playing the Bounty Hunter, heading to the offlane with this very nice Soul Shield deployed. It is bad slow game. On the Mirana, no one else than the carry player of Lowyard. We have Lance looking to finish his Ring of Basilius pretty soon into the game. Then we have Shadow Demon being played by Shang Zai with some wards in his inventory, the Dispersion Debut,
30
and nothing
seconds
else. And of
remaining.
course we have Mosion denying the middle lane, playing the Enigma, denying for DDZ on the Nyx Assassin.
On the side of Titan, we have got Miracle. Looks like he's going to be playing an easy lane Outworld Devourer, playing probably the primary farming role, I guess. Probably going for a 4-star, maybe into a straight Hex. Extinct is going to be on that Chant of the Jungle. Of course, Woman Killer, aka Ice, is going to be playing the Bane. KOXY on the mid Viper, and Ohio is going to be on the offlane Elder Titan. And yeah, I mean, denying this mid creep will give it a little bit of frustration, I suppose, to KOXY on the Viper, but it's not going to be the end of the world for him. I mean, he's basically just there to kind of harass DDZ outer lane and get as much farm up as possible. And I mean, the lane's going to be pushing back. Nice blocking there by Mosin in the mid lane. But still, I mean, he's going to get what farm he needs. And Women Killer actually picking up a DD rune, and I wonder where he's going. Maybe he's just going to go plant some wards. They haven't got a rune ward down yet. And it looks like, where's he going? He's going for a bit of a run. Oh, he's going to be putting it here defensively for a bit of extra survivability there for that Elder
Yeah.
Titan. But it is spotted out immediately, so they will go dewarded straight away, and that's going to be that rune ward for the Dire Gorn thus far. So no rune control really for KYXY unless Extinct and Ice do decide to defend it for him.
And I will limit the Viper a bit. I mean, it's not the biggest of the deals, just because Viper has like not the biggest impact with the bottle. He can. I don't think he will pick up a bottle in this game if he goes with the Wraith ban first. And he got pulled quite a bit of regen. So we'll see how that goes. It's nice. But interestingly enough, we see a 2 versus 2 situation on the middle lane, on the bottom lane, I'm sorry. So what is your thought? Who has the stronger lane there?
Well, I would say that the stronger lane is going to be coming out from Titan. Sorry, not Titan, from Loyat. But I think it's not quite nice that Womankiller Ice is kind of just sitting down. They're giving Ahaya a bit of support. Ahaya didn't pick up boots first. He does have the boots up now. But this means that, it's not going to be so much worry about him being initiated on. Plus, Outworld Devourer needs levels. I mean, he normally plays a solo hero in the mid lane. So, running him as a solo easy lane hero is going to be quite a lot of farm onto him, and that's going to be quite nice. And actually, Xiangzai is going to initiate there. Arrow not going to be coming out. Lance cares not for your petty engagements. No, he will be throwing out an arrow, landing
Oh
right onto
no.
Womankiller, and this could be a first blood going the way of Loyat. The Artist auto attacking him down. Womankiller not going anywhere. He does manage to get a sleep off into Lance, but I don't think it's going to be enough. And first blood will be going the way of Mosin on that Enigma, who just came over to throw down a random little Malphite, and that's going to be his Sol Ring up already. So a really good little exchange there. Going the way of Loyat. And actually, Viper in mid lane is going to be taken down by DDZ as well as Bad Slow Game, who rotated over. So, good rotations from Loyat, I suppose, across the map. Bad Slow Game as well as Mosin both just helping out to get some kills.
No, on the bot lane, actually, Ahaya taking very much damage. A nice defensive sleep coming out, and Ahaya, he's bottling up now, and he's fine. Looks like Xiangzai is in a bit of trouble. No, he isn't. And everything's fine now. It looked like they could make a play on Ahaya, but it's great there. Like, the bot lane is very hard now, just because of the levels going the way of Lance and the Shadow Demon. Lance is already level 4, and the arrow to boot onto Ice. Ice taking very much damage, actually, really got down. Now he can't sleep himself, so that's not the biggest problem there. But still, nice harassment coming out.
Yeah, they are doing a really good job of just trying to force his support Bane off. And this is why Bane normally isn't seen in aggressive tri lane, because he's got virtually no staying ability in lane. All of his spells cost a lot of mana, and he needs to usually be pulling to get his levels up. And on this off lane, I mean, he has to watch out, because if he gets caught out of position, he's pretty much going to be going down. And of course, Xiangzai is just pulling constantly, so his levels aren't really being found. And he's also just taking levels from Ahaya, but really he's got nowhere else to go. He doesn't want to pull on the top lane because Bad Slow Game could pretty easily, I would say, get a kill onto Miracle if Miracle doesn't watch out. Bad Slow Game doesn't care too much about losing all of his intelligence. He's got the Janata anyway to do a fair amount of damage, and I wouldn't be surprised if he does decide to pick up a fast Orb of Venom just
Yeah.
to get that extra slow going.
Actually, looking at the mid lane, KYXY is outlaning DDZ quite a bit. He is not. Wait, why isn't he level 5? Well, I don't understand, but he is on top of the CS, so that's pretty nice. He's 20 and 5 against the Nyx Assassin 10 and 2, so that's looking quite nice already. On the top lane, Bounty Hunter is getting something. He's 11 and 2 against the Outworld Devourer's 23 and 10. Miracle doing a great job with denying experience from the Bounty Hunter. Although he's level 5 already, so maybe we'll see some big rotation coming out as soon as he hits level 6.
Yeah, I can imagine when he hits level 6, they probably want to get a pick off on Miracle, but it's worth noting that Miracle has been pulled centuries by the Bane before the Bane left the lane. So, I mean, I think Miracle probably wants to go for a kill fairly soon onto Bad Slow Game, if Bad Slow Game
No,
does come
KYX were
forward.
taking a lot of damage in the mid lane, but he won't go down. A nice spike from DDZ, but it's not enough. And Ahaya's on pursuit. He's trying very hard, but an arrow too? Well, nothing. Nothing's happening right now. No one's dying. Just Enigma on the chase, and they will find a stun on Ice, and will Ice go down? There's a dispersion ready for this Shadow Demon. But Ice still. Yeah, this is a stun to seal the deal, and he should go down. 3-0 now. But KYXY, he's coming in and he's trying to get a kill on Mosin, but Mosin, he's going to just TP off DDZ as well. Xiangzai, he is left alone, but he will take it for the team. Not the
He
biggest
just
of deals
accepts his
there.
fate.
Yeah, he's just standing there like, well, that's how it goes.
Doop 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 doop. Well, of course, Lance is just free farming while this is happening. In terms of CS, he's really not doing so hot, only 16 to 6. And, I mean, when you compare that to Miracle, he's on twice the CS of him, more than twice the CS, that's not the best start for Morana. But of course, he has been trying to help out with kills and playing a bit more of a rotating based Morana, so I guess it's not too surprising. But it looks like he's going for a Midas, so he probably does want to pick that up fairly soon. I mean, if you're going for a Midas, you really want to have it as fast as possible. But of course, I guess last hitting is fairly hard when you're versing a Bane with Enfeeble. So
Yeah.
now he's going to be in a lot of trouble. I mean, he's only got 30-ish damage.
Yeah, how can you last it with 30 damage? Oh, he managed to get the kill,
Difficulty.
right? Well, it's hard. Game is hard for him. This is pretty crazy. I mean, the Bane, yeah, he died twice, but he shuts down this farming Mirana so hard just because you can't last it. And now they make a go. Shanxi with a disruption, arrow to boot, perfect play! And Bounty Hunter's here as well. Will he get the track off? I'm not sure. Did he? I don't think so. So this wasn't
He
a
wasn't
track
level
kill.
6, he just hit level 6, now they're going in, chasing after Woman Killer. And will he be able to get the kill? Lance has got the arrow back up in 1 second. They will use a. Oh, no, they're gonna get the kill. He used a. Whatchamacallit? Brain Sap to try and get a little bit more health. But now Lance is in a bit of trouble. He hasn't got the leap. Nice arrow flying onto Ohio, but rotation from Extinct, and he just
Well
gets
played.
dropped. That Astral Spirit from Astral Order. But now, oh, KYXY with a Haste Rune, chasing down Xiangzai. Badso game, trying to help out, but he could be going down as well if he doesn't watch out. But no, he should be okay. Making out are all right. And DDZ popped up Vendetta to try and get a kill in the mid lane, but nobody there. And Bane cancels his TP since he doesn't
So,
want to die.
yeah, that's actually quite a problem. I mean, Mirana going down, she doesn't do that great on the CS chart. I mean, she's just 18 and 6, and now she died. So that's a big problem. And the Viper, he has his mech coming up in, like, I would say, around the 10-minute mark. Not sure. Oh, we see some more rotations coming out. Shang Tsai is here now. Are they gonna make a go in the Mirana? Oh, what a play by Extinct. And Lance is forced to use his ultimate. Will he go invisible in time? Yes, he is. A shockwave for fishing? Nope, nothing happening. And now they could turn this around. Does Enigma have his ultimate? Yes, she does. So we will see some big team fight, most like. No, no, no. Arrow, arrow, and a team fight, please. Motion, please hold.
I think Mosin can't just find the room to ult that he needs. Ohio's taking a lot of damage, but KYXY could be the one in trouble. Vendetta's going to be going off DDZ, ignoring KYXY, who's just doing so much damage. Black Hole is going to be going off behind the tower. Mosin on one hit, and he does manage to take down two. Ohio, though, will turn around, just hiding in the bushes there. DDZ unable to find him, and Ohio, though, doesn't have a TP scroll, so he's just stuck down there. DDZ hunting on him. Can he find him is the question. Ohio will be caught out now. Stun going out from DDZ, but I don't know if DDZ has enough damage. He's trying to block him in, trying to just do anything he can, but Ohio is just way too tanky. 4 armor, 300 health left, and he's gonna make it out a-okay. Still really nice by Cole. Actually, no, he's not going to. Another stun from DDZ. Can he do enough damage? But no, Ohio pops the one. DDZ just doesn't do enough attack damage. Not gonna be finding the kill.
Too bad. Now, checking the gold graph, it is a roller coaster, but it's not really big of a deal. It's just like 200 gold in favor of Loya. This is nothing at this point. The experience is another thing here. It's a 1700, no, it's nearly 2k experience going the way of Titan. And if you're running such a lineup as Titan, it's very important to keep up with the levels. And they're doing a great job. Only Bane is level 4, everyone else is level 7 or above. So they're making a great use of the jungling Chen just to keep his levels up, and he will be a force to be reckoned with. We already saw him doing work in the bottom lane, so I'll expect Chen to just rotate even a bit more and absolutely go ham on the towers off low yet.
Yeah, but I mean, of course, Miracle this whole time has been free farm. He's picked up a 9-minute four staff.
Bottom,
And on bot lane,
KYX were taken.
oh,
Oh, go
KYXY.
ahead.
Oh, no, he's dead. Vendetta
Whoa.
hit. That was a track kill, so a nice amount of gold going the way of those three heroes there. Nothing to complain about there.
Yeah, and it's a reliable goal as well, so that's quite nice to have. Just you know, nice surf stuff. And now they look to make a go on the bot lane. No, they don't. Nope. All right. Well, tower won't take too much damage. It's not the best tower pushing lineup of those two heroes in the bot lane. In the meantime, actually, top lane. Tower's gonna fall. Miracle is on pursuit, but he won't catch the leaping Mirana. An arrow? Arrow? Nope. Well, creep. Hashtag value.
Yay! Well, still a nice pushing coming out into the top lane from Titan. Doing a fair amount of damage to the tower, as much as they really can do. If Chen wants to rotate over, they probably could get the tower down, but it looks like Miracle is just saying, get out of my lane, I want to farm. As he does. He's going to be coming around behind the lane, but there's nobody there to catch. But still, I mean, Miracle now, 4 stuff up, so he's going to be very hard to touch. And, I mean, when you compare his net worth to Lance, who is the comparable farmer, Lance is 2.5, Miracle is 4.1. So, Lance is really not having a great time. And, I mean, his items have not changed. actually, no, you got a ring of Aquila up, but still, no phase boots, no
oh,
minus
bottom
to be
lane,
seen.
Camo Expert taking so much damage, but this is some big rotations coming in. Ohio throwing out the Earth Splitter, no one's taken damage from it, but it's a nice just zoning out tool there, and everyone's on pursuit, but they don't have Dust or Sentries, I think, with them. No, it doesn't look like. So a nice Moonlight Shadow coming out, saving the day for Lowyard, and that was a big commitment, going the way of Camo XY, who has a smack in 400 gold, so this is great.
Yeah, it would have been really nice if they could have taken him down for Lowyard, just to get another couple of kills in their favor, but ultimately, I mean, not dying is probably just as good at this point of the game, and I mean, Lance is getting a bit of farm on the top lane, and that's something they really desperately need. They can't just keep leaving Lance getting picked off constantly and getting forced out of lane, but of course, this T1 tower is going to be going down now. There's a, what, four-man push. Exceed is sitting on the top lane, but this might mean that Titan are intending on just all TPing into the top lane and pushing down the next T1 as they go if Extinct isn't leaving that lane. But there could be a big team fight coming off. Sleep is going to be going into Shang Tsai. KY Expert's going in, but Miracle just disrupts him on the sideline. Then in comes Enigma. He wants to get a black hole, but he's trying to target out Miracle, who forced himself into the bushes. But Miracle just turns around, black hole into two, but KY Expert is not caught in it. Moses is just going to get three hit down, but Ohio will be the one to fall. Miracle stuck in the trees here. He doesn't know where to go, but he's going to turn around, just drop the Sanity's Eclipse. Huge damage coming out. Batso Game trying to kill off Miracle, and he will get him down, but KY Expert at the same time takes down Batso Game. They're chasing down KY Expert, but I don't think they're going to be able to kill him. And at the same time, Extinct just pushed down that top tower, and Lance is stuck in the trees.
Yeah. That was sick. It was a 4 versus 5, and still Titan came out ahead, I would say. And in the same time, the tower was taken by Extinct, so just pretty nice play, I would say. Being 4v5 on the enemy tower, just diving. The Bane went a bit very much YOLO just in this section, like below the trees. Well, I don't know if that was really necessary, but it was great nonetheless. So they're keeping up, and they're making the plays, and the mechanism is finished now on Viper, as well with 1.2k gold. He just bought something. Ah, it's a point booster, so he's rushing this Aghanim Scepter. Nice pickup there.
Very, very hard now. I mean, Titan are just using the advantage they've got in terms of, experience, I guess. I mean, they're kind of out-leveling. In terms of gold, it's not that far ahead, but Black Hole's on cooldown, and that's really the big AoE spell coming out from Lowyard. And actually, Sleep gonna be going off into Batso Game. Oh, he's got nowhere to go. He can't even go Invis. He just gets two or three hit by KYXY along with the damage coming out from Ohio, and that natural order doing a lot of work with KYXY's physical damage. I mean, it really just rips through you in the early game. And yeah, Titan are just going to be getting as much map control as possible, which is something they should be doing. They have got now the mech as well as the blink dagger up onto the Nyx Assassin, so this could be a bit of a turnaround for them in terms of teamfights, but Arrow not landing onto Miracle, and that's probably what they needed to win the teamfight, or at least initiate it efficiently.
Yeah, if you think about it, the Enigma went for a mechanism, and while the mechanism is a great teamfight tool, they don't have pretty much anything to go in if Titan carries sentries, and Titan is a pretty smart team, so they will do that just like in the nick of time. So they don't have anything really to initiate. The Nyx Assassin can't go in. Does he have a dagger? No. Oh, he does have a dagger, right, so this is some initiation at least, but still they could like really need a dagger on the Enigma, and she won't have it up for the next 5 minutes, so this is an easy Roche, and they can't really contest it at all.
Yeah, I mean, they don't. I mean, the Black Hole is pretty much the whole team, but it looks like they're going to be trying to go in, but Batso Game going to get caught up by KYXY. Stun onto KYXY will be slowing him down. It looks like Batso Game should be good to just kind of run away on half health just from that one engagement. GDZ with the Vendetta up, maybe wants to get a pick off on anyone, but Titan are just 5-manning, and the biggest counter to an invisibility gank-based lineup is going to be 5-manning, and DDZ gets caught out by the sentry ward freshly planted down there. So this is the problem when you pick up three invisibility heroes with the Nyx Assassin, the Mirana, and the Bounty Hunter, is that it's really, really hard to fight against Titan when they just carry sentries and 5-man. I mean, what can you really do against that? It's like nothing you can do. You can't initiate in. You can't go in. They're relying completely on the Enigma to have the black hole, but that black hole's only up once every 3 or so minutes. And if that black hole is down, well then, how do Lowyard fight? What do they have to initiate the team fights or go in with?
Well, good thing is Enigma is actually the top farm on the side of Lowyard. I don't know if that's actually good, like per se, but they need a blink dagger on her just so they can make the plays. And the tier 2 middle will fall, there's no doubt about it. Just the Chen army coming out and everyone just TPing back. Can they make something happen? Nope, doesn't look like it. So, yeah, easy game So far, from Titan, perfectly played. So we'll see that Lowyard has to make some plays happen, and the Bounty Hunter's on pursuit. He wants to take down the Chen. They have some wards there. Oh well, they pinged it out. Will he make a go? Yes, he will. Is it enough? We will see. Nope. Ah, very smart, very smart. Ah, he's sealing up. And Nyx Assassin coming in as well. And now this could be a stun. No, this is a mana drain. And this is a turnaround coming from this thing. Perfectly chain stunned there. And actually, he's gonna go down. Bounty Hunter, wow. What a play coming out from Extinct. And is he gonna get... No, this is the arrow just going onto a creep. Ice is on the run. Is he gonna get away? No, a nice double stun coming out from the Nyx Assassin, but everyone has to disengage. Ooh, the Earth Splitter just missing. And Lance, will he get away? Will he get away? One more anything? Urn? No, Urn won't do it. Alright.
Arrow!
Nope. Nope. Too bad, too bad. But well, they really need those arrows. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, they really do. I mean, Miracle's not there. So it could be a really nice time for them to fight. 4v5 situation if they wanted to go in. But it looks like they're going to be the ones who get initiated on KYX White is coming forward and throwing out some spells. And KYX White is very, very close to having out that Arcanine Scepter, which is going to be, well, just devastating for Lowyard. They've got no way to deal with it. And in they go, DDZ getting a nice two-man stun. In comes the track. They're trying to take down Extinct before he can get that Hand of God off. But the Hand of God's already on cooldown, so I don't know what they're trying to do. But Badso Game will be the one they target. Mosin coming in. Black Hole onto only one. Very unfortunate. KYXY is now getting very, very low. KYXY will go down, but in comes Miracle. He forced himself across the map, taking down Mosin. Now, oh, poor Badso Game is stuck in a bad situation. He's been going down as well, and Lance is DC'd, so... He's running back to the base, I guess.
Oh, that's unfortunate. He didn't use the arrow there.
Yeah, not a great team vibe for them. I don't know if I agree with Max in the arrow, though. I mean, I know Lowyard wanted to go for ganking, but I feel like going for Staff Storm Max would have helped a lot more out in the team fights, which is probably what they needed. I mean, given that they didn't have enough damage to really kill anyone, or at least they kill one person, there's four other people just staring them in the face. That Staff Storm, which is 300 damage in AoE, I think would have been fantastic for them.
Yeah, especially with an Enigma Black Hole. I mean, it's 300 damage on everyone standing in there, and they rely on the Black Hole. It is all their game plan. Just get this sick 5 or 4 man Black Hole up, and just kill everyone in it. But this is just not happening, so... Enigma died, which sets her back quite tremendously on the Blink Dagger route. She's only on 1k gold right now, and... Bad Slow Gain disconnecting as well. So, Yui just, you know, cursing people left and right.
Making him very sad. Oh, now all Lowyard's disappearing. Well, if you look at the gold graph, yeah, 7,500 experience. The items for Lowyard that they really need to find, I mean, Bounty Hunter, I mean, he doesn't need too much, but I mean, poor Lance, he's only got up a Midas and a Ring of Aquila. That's it, it's 17 minutes into the game. You can pair that with Miracle, who's got Necronomicon 1 and a 4 staff, and he could afford Necronomicon 2 if he wanted to buy it. And really, they're just not, they're not really keeping up. I mean, look at Lance's net worth. He's comparable to the nobody, just because he's DC'd. but yeah, I mean, he's still just nowhere near as farmed as anyone else. Like you were saying, Enigma topping the net worth chart. I mean, it's good, but Enigma's kind of a one-hit wonder. He blinks and gets a black hole, and then that's it. Like, for the rest of the team fight, what are you going to do? Especially if the black hole gets cancelled. Like what are they going to do then when the black hole's down?
Yeah, and the thing is, with the Elder Titan Earth Splitter coming out, you can't even pick a B. And of course, there's a Fiend's Grip, so what are you gonna do? I don't know. I really don't know how Lowyard can go back onto this game. Maybe Titan decides to make a major throw, but I very much doubt it. They're playing so well at the moment, just taking every opportunity, taking every tower, just making the plays happen. So Lowyard has to step up the game. Or, well, I'm not sure if they can now in this stage. They made some good rotations in the early game, pretty much winning the bottom lane for a certain amount. Until Lance was just enfeebled all day long, 24/7. So, yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think the Lowyard at this point, they're going to be forced into defending inside the base, but I mean, all Titan really need to do is just keep the pressure up and just kind of sit there and chip away at all the towers. They've got such a big gold advantage, and they've still got the Aegis up in Miracle, do they not? Yes, Miracle's still got the Aegis, so how are they really... I don't know. I think this game is just going to be really hard for Lowyard at this point. I mean, the gold isn't insurmountable, and neither is the experience, but they need a good team fight. And I mean, they probably need to take KYXY down first. Or Miracle down first, or maybe even the Elder Titan down first. I mean, all of those heroes are kind of primary targets. Miracle does huge damage. Elder Titan buffs the huge damage that Miracle's doing, and Viper does huge damage himself. And then, of course, you got the Bane, who disables everyone, and the Chen, who heals everyone. So, I mean, every single target on Titan is the kind of one you'd want to kill off. And, they have enough difficulty just killing off one. I mean, it took two heroes to take down just a Viper.
I'm dropping frames at the moment, just a second. My dear Twitch, please do not fail me. Ah, it's looking good again. So, sorry guys for the hiccup. It's mostly Twitch, because my net currently is pretty damn stable, but I can't, like, change it, so. Sorry, but the game is paused, so everything's fine. Aight. So. Now, this is the biggest question as a broadcaster, like as a commentator. What do you do when the game is paused for like 20 minutes?
I haven't figured it out yet.
You
I normally
haven't.
just kill myself.
Oh, so you can't do that too often, I guess.
Do it like once a day, I guess.
Idea, that sounds reasonable. So I wonder what chat thinks about this. So, dear chat, what are your suggestions, Jesus Christ, my English, to fill out this downtime? Because I don't think there's a large delay, right?
No, I don't know. I don't know what happened with the delay. Like, it's meant to be set to 2 minutes, but it's not for some
Well,
reason.
just don't tell anyone and then we'll be fine.
Yeah, there is delay, guys. There is delay.
And everyone complaining about it. There's nothing going on, like, literally nothing.
Yeah.
Like, game's paused, game's hard.
I know. I might as well like earn some money to pay my bills by playing ads because we have run out of things to talk about, and there is nothing happening.
Well, how dare
There are
you,
too many
like,
things to see.
make a living?
How dare I not? It's all right.
Is caster paid to cast? What a question. No, I won't confess to Lily. Sorry, chat. It's kinda hard, you know? Germany and Aussie, and Lily has a boyfriend, so it's like not the easiest thing in the world.
Okay, well, chat's just gone crazy. They want you to play Sandstorm.
Oh, Sandstorm. Yeah, we can do that, like, no problem. Wait, let me get this on low. Alright, chat. You know what? You can get Sandstorm if the KPM goes, let's say, above 500. Right? So 500 KPM is equals Sandstorm.
They're not gonna be able to do it.
Ah, I don't think so. Yesterday we had like 900 on 9K viewers. I'm Stewie from Family Guy. Well, that's nice. I can go with that. Thanks. And I don't know what Pictionary is. I'm a bit
Pictionary is a
dumb.
game where you draw something and someone else has to guess it.
Ah, Pimp has a boyfriend. No, I do not. Although that would be great.
Have to say, sometimes when you say stuff, you really sound like Arnold Schwarzenegger. I'm gonna be totally honest. It makes me
The
laugh.
Austrian guy with a heavy German accent. Yes, I can do that.
Oh my god, that's atrocious. But like, awesome.
Yeah, I can make a cast visit, the Arnold Schwarzenegger cast here on Door to Talk TV. So guys, what do you think? Oh, there's a KPM rising. It's around
What's the
100
KP?
now.
You should cast like that for the rest of the game.
Nah, I can't do it.
I would actually just sit here laughing.
Yes, but the people demand you, yourself for the people to cast, and I don't do it. Pim sounds drunk and sleepy. Hell yeah, I do. I slept like 5 hours, sorry. Alright, a bit more, like 6. Well, KPM's around like 250, so you have to go high. Please, my people, raise the KPM. Thank you. The Schwarzenegger demands it, otherwise, I won't be governor next year. Thanks. Well, it's 300 KPM, guys. You have to break 500.
Oh my god.
Well,
Oh, what's going on? Oh, they're
someone
reconnecting.
reconnected.
That's exciting.
No, I'm not Ark Vince. Dude, I'm from Germany. What the hell? Well, it's still around 300. What
Yeah, can you
race
say
are
get to
you?
the chopper?
Get to the chopper! Like this?
Chopper. Great. Perfect. It's only about 300. These guys suck at making high KPM.
I am Arnold Pimpenegger. Hello. Well, it's still below 400. Jesus Christ. Oh, it's 390. Can they break it? Dear chat, come on, raise the KPM. It's. Oh, wow, you broke 400. 440. Will we see the KPM rising to 500? This is the question here. And it's on
There we go.
516. This is it. We're gonna play Sandstorm. But they can't start. Alright, so, Sandstorm. Where's Sandstorm?
Quickly. Quickly play the sandstorm.
Wait. Alright, because I only have like an extended. Alright, Sandstorm for you guys. You did it. I'm so proud. The Schwarzenegg is very proud, and they're gonna turn out some music. Yeah, easy.
Professionals.
Yeah, totally. I can't even read anything. Saying.
Not in the game, they're talking Chinese.
Oh.
They said don't talk.
I was like, do do do.
Schwarzenegger impressions.
No, no, we have to be sensible.
Okay. Who's that kid? Is that you? Oh my god, that's you?
Yeah.
That is not how I expected you to look.
That kid, yeah, thanks. I was just raving, you know? I mean, I'm not a good commentator, but I can entertain shit sometimes. So. Yeah, that was me, the kid. You hear that? Like. Can you please spam delete to not be so evil?
Oh, sorry. By your voice, you look like you're like 5 foot, you know, no, like 6 foot 5, like 200 kilogram hulking German man, like Arnold Schwarzenegger. That's what your voice sounds like. That wasn't meaning
oh, really?
To be insulting. I'm sorry.
Well, I can go with that. Like, no, I'm like, I have no idea of Imperial units, so I have no clue what you just said. No, I won't dance. That was it. And I won't striptease for you, chat. No.
Dance.
I mean, you can pay me rares, like, no big deal. 200 rares and I go, oh, no, wait, I don't.
We had it here first, guys. 200 rares and Pitbuck will do a dance for you on cam. I gotta get Tom Repression.
Damn.
Damn, he's not online.
Yeah, Repression would be here, like, all day.
He would just be like going crazy if
oh,
he heard
yeah.
you say
Most gay shit ever. Right, I'm totally done with it. Totally not.
Russian loves you so much.
Yeah, he like spammed me.
Doesn't surprise me. Oh my
Jesus
god, the
Christ.
chat is dead. We just broke the chat.
I have 200 rares. Yeah, well, trade me. I'll pay you 3 rares to take off shirt. No! I'm not that cheap. What the hell? Like, I'm German, I'm not something.
You're a rares prostitute. How does
Yeah,
that make
easy
you
rares,
feel?
right? I mean. Gift Lily Dance. Well, that's gonna be a bit hard, I guess. 5,400 rares here. Yeah. So apparently, chat really likes the idea of you dancing.
Yeah, chat can. I won't say what I'm thinking, but I'm sure people know what I'm thinking.
Alright, what could we play as well? Thing
We are
is,
electric
yeah,
like that.
but I have only the fake one, the not real We Are Electric, so. Alright, let's see.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not DVBBS. BGM? Let's try this. Yeah, got it!
This is like the longest pause ever.
Yeah. Thank God we have the Schwarzenegger here to like make us play out of it of the pause. Otherwise we couldn't talk about anything.
Yes, I was watching you to save the day.
Nice. We just had Sandstorm. Jesus Christ.
People just never stop winning Sandstorm, though.
Pendulum, I mean, I can go with Pendulum. I freaking love Pendulum. Well, keeping a stream PG-13 is really hard. Today and not. Wait, can I summon this?
Christmas carols on. People love Christmas carols.
Oh, really? I should probably put some Germans on and everyone be like, what the fuck? Good thing is.
Do you have like German Christmas carols?
Oh, yeah. Of course. Well, well. What do we do now?
I don't know.
Wait, I try to get a window capture in for you.
Oh
Oh! Timing! Alright, guys, so Mirana is back into the game. So Mirana can get back to the chopper.
Yay.
And we're going again. I don't even remember what happened in the game, but we should be good now. Arrow?
So Necrobook 2 picked up onto Miracle, sitting in the base. He's got the four staff. He's gonna go forward. They're trying to get a stop. They will get a stop off to Lance. Lance is gonna be in a lot of trouble. He will get Astral imprisoned. He should be okay to sleep out from that, but he wants to go forward and use that might on something. But he's probably not gonna be able to do that.
Aaron Bane. But they can't follow it up. There's no way.
Yeah, I mean, they can't really fight until that black hole's back up, and that's what we were talking about, but that's still 150 seconds away, so what are they really going to be able to do? It looks like they're going to be going in, though. They're trying to catch Miracle out. Miracle is just going to get sent back to base by the Chen, though. Extinct TPing out on the side. Arrow! Not going to land on anyone, but Extinct does actually get stunned up by DBZ, so Extinct will be going down from this.
Well, at least I got something from it. Looking at the map vision, yeah. Titan is in firm control of the map right now. Loviot doesn't have any vision. I mean, they have the lanes, and they're somehow pushed out. I mean, they're here and here, but that's it. So they can't really farm the jungle. And Enigma needs a dagger. And a refresher. And a BKB. And a Lincoln Sphere. But, well... Oh...
I don't know if BKB is going to be absolutely essential this game, honestly. Actually, Bane going to get... Well, sleep onto bad slow game there. He's like... How did he even do that? Does he have a gem?
No, that's a ward. Oh, yeah, Miracle taking so much damage. But she just drops the hammer. Everyone just dying there. So much damage coming out from Miracle. DDZ now netted in, and he's gonna take a fall. Miracle will have his Aegis triggered, and Mojin's gonna TP out. But everyone on the side of Loya just very low are dying. And actually, Ice, he will find Lance, and Lance is gonna get dropped as well. If there's the stuns. No, there's not. That was cooldown, right? Yeah, cooldown from the stuns. So, most likely Lance will get away with his incredible move speed. A nice arrow to boot. And... yeah, he should be good.
But still, they did lose three from that little scuffle there. All they got was the Aegis in return, so not even a real kill. And not really the ideal team fighting, I suppose, for Loya just there. And Titan looked like they're ready to just pull back and get a little bit more farm up. The Aegis was going to expire in a moment anyway, and Necronomicon 3 now picked up onto Miracle. So with that, maybe they're going to go take the tier 2 bot tower, or maybe they're just going to go decide to push in the mid lane. They're really going to be free to do whatever they like at this point. So many items coming up for them.
Yeah, Roshana's back in around 2.5 minutes, plus, of course, his variable respawn time of around, like, 1.5 minutes, and then they should make a go as... if they even wait for the Aegis. They are so strong right now, they could just barrel down mid lane, make a beeline for the tower, and just take it down. Enigma Black Hole, 19 seconds, so they will have that going for them. And if Enigma gets a nice Black Hole up, everything's possible, but they will have to play perfect.
Yeah, they're really going to have to make sure they play it very, very safely, and oh, it looks like Mosin's going to be in a bit of trouble. Killer is going to get a nice dump, sorry, sleep off there, followed up by a double stomp by Extinct, and Mosin just drops down very, very quickly.
Yep, that's not what you want to have as Enigma if you're still trying to get a dagger up. And Viper finishes the Aghanim Scepter, so this is going to be, what, 12 seconds cooldown? Yeah, 12 seconds cooldown, and so much slow coming out in the teamfight just to shut pretty much every melee down. Bounty Hunter and Exorcism, they won't, like, be able to move at all. And even the damage is just pretty incredible at this point. So...
looks like they don't want to lose this... Oh, arrow from Lance. And DDZ is actually going to follow up, but I don't know if they have enough damage to take KYXY down. They're really trying to, but KYXY is going to get tracked out now. One more TP in, and he does pop the mech as well as Hand of God, and he might turn this around, taking down Lance. No, he's getting very, very low, but what a defensive imprisonment, saving his life. And now DDZ will just come out and get that last synonym, but Dartsoy Game is going to be falling in exchange, getting eaten at the tower by that Fiend's Grip and Mega Kill Streak onto Miracle. That was a huge save right there onto Miracle. I mean, onto KYXY, just for that extra second.
Yeah, he's so tanky with the smack popped and the Chen heal. I mean, they used pretty much everything on him, and Titan used everything they could just to get him down. And nice rotation coming out from Miracle just to save him pretty much in time. The next Assassin Impale was, of course, perfectly timed, but still, it was so much just stuff throwing at him. And yeah, well, they paid the price. So
yeah, they definitely did. I mean, they got the track kill, but still... it's not really worth it. I mean, it takes so long to take down KYXY that it gives time for everyone else to rotate in and give him a hand. And I mean, Lance is going for a BKB as his next item, but I don't know if BKB is going to be that much help, honestly. Viper's ult goes through the BKB. Actually, DDZ going in onto Wumia, decision he regrets. Bazzle game is going to get trapped out. And Chen is running in with his stun brigade, and he's going to get even Earth Splitter right across his head, and that's going to be the death of him. And now Titan could really push the high ground if they wanted to. Shangzai should be going down as well. He does do one nice last second defensive disruption on himself, but now Ohio just says whatever and one hits him in the face with that plus 107 damage.
And now it's looking really grim. 20 seconds on two of the heroes of Lowyard, and they could do some considerable amount of damage on the tier 3 of Lowyard right now, and they're going for it. They don't have the best pushing lineup in the game, but still, it's so much if you have the nice lead they have. And look at Ohio just taking pretty much the tower down on his own. A Chen army to boot, and a nice positioning from everyone on Titan, to be honest. And Lance, look at the damage just coming out from the Spirit,
Oh
and he's
my
getting
god.
stunned.
He's
What?
forced to leap back into the team. I think he might have misclicked there, I'm not too sure, but either way, Lance going down. Ohio descending out the image, even if he hadn't got the stomp off, just the Astral Spirit having that natural order would have been enough to take down. Oh, a
Oh.
huge black hole, latching onto two heroes, but no, it doesn't matter because Viper just auto attacks him down. Nothing else to follow up, they haven't got any other AoE, and the Rax in the mid lane is going to be going down now. Astral Imprisonment onto the Bad Slow game, he's doing what he can to survive, but he is going to be falling as well. So three down now from Lowyard, and I can't imagine that GG is going to be far away. Titan at this point could push in the top lane next and get two lanes of Rax before even probably Enigma's respawned.
Yeah, also Lowyard doesn't have the best anti-push in the game. So,
yeah,
it's looking grim. Ah! Just to annoy Kamax where he's getting stunned, but he will maybe pay with his life. This is so not worth it, and DDZ is going out. He's gonna get slapped. Some disruption going on, someone is in there. Who is it? Changzai. He's saving himself just for the second, and yeah, well, that's it. Elder Titan to finish him off. This is pretty much game. A buyback from the Nyx Assassin, but what can he do on his own? There's Enigma, but she doesn't have a black hole. There's a Mirana, but she isn't really farmed. And a Bounty Hunter just to respawn, but well, it's a Bounty Hunter, and they have so much anti-inv standing there. Now he goes. Everything on KYXY. He's getting Astral imprisoned by Miracle, and he's getting saved. There's a Hand of God. Is the mechanism ready? Yes, it's ready, so no problem there. Lance will take an ultimate from KYX. Well, doesn't even need it. And DDZ immediately stunned out. A little bit of miscommunication coming out from Titan, but not the biggest of deal. The game is pretty much won. DDZ getting stunned. Nice by Carapace, but the Osplitter to finish the deal. Viper's taking the kill there. And now they're just diving. Yeah, GG is gonna get called out, and this is a 2-0 for Titan Esports. Well played by both teams, but especially Titan.
Yeah. Well, Titan played very, very well. Lowyard did what they could, but unfortunately the tri-core style didn't work, and neither did their aggressive ganking style. Either way, they did the best considering Titan is one of the best teams in Southeast Asia at the moment. So GG, well played to both teams. Thank you, of course, to SteelSeries for sponsoring this tournament. Shout out to DatBet.net, esports betting. Thanks to DotaTalk for very kindly allowing me and Pimpbuckle to cast this tournament. And thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you in the next game, which is going to be First Departure versus Mineski, coming up in 50 minutes. So see you all then.
Right, bye.